Probably one of the most difficult things for any Scrivener user to learn is all the features the app has to offer and which ones will work best for their writing process. In this video, I'm going to give a quick rundown of the top 10 features in Scrivener that you probably didn't know existed. You're going to thank me when this video is over. What's up, guys? This is Michael Aron with Author Level Up, giving you the best tools and strategies for writing faster and reaching readers with your stories. Writing faster is easy with Scrivener, especially Scrivener 3. If you haven't already, check out my ultimate Scrivener 3 review video. Writing faster is easier with Scrivener, but there are features in the app that not everyone knows about. These features will make your life easier. With the exception of one, all of these features are available on both the Mac and Windows versions. Let's get to it, shall we? Number 10 is Import Pages. Sometimes you need to import not only images into your Scrivener binder, but an entire web page. You say you're doing research, for example. Scrivener lets you do that with the click of a button. If you use a note-taking app like Evernote or Microsoft OneNote, you can import your notes directly into Scrivener so that they can live in your project. Number 9, Smart Quote Conversion. All quotes aspire to be curly. Straight quotes are just the mark of an amateur formatter. Not only do straight quotes look unprofessional in ebooks, they look even worse in paperbacks. Readers have come to expect curly, smart quotes. So as you can see in this example, we've got straight quotes, which is a no-no. If we go to Edit, Substitutions, and then turn on Smart Quotes, and type the sentence again, we get much more aesthetically pleasing quotes. Scrivener 3 automatically converts quotes to smart quotes for you, but if you're using Scrivener 2 or below, you can convert quotes to smart quotes by selecting this feature under the Format tab. Smart quotes are a simple technique that will make your books look much more professional. Number 8 is the name generator. This is a fun one. Why use a Google search for an interesting name when Scrivener can generate one for you? You can use the name generator tool under Edit, Writing Tools to generate names for your next character. You can choose male names, female names, or both. You can also choose if you want alliteration, you know, some fun double-barreled surnames, or the ethnicity, if you want. Any ethnicity you want is here. Seriously, from Catalan to Finnish to Irish to Italian to Polish, any name you can imagine is in the character name database. Hit that Generate Names button and boom, you've got yourself a bunch of names to choose from. This is definitely one of the nice-to-have features versus need-to-have, but you may find it useful one day. Number 7 is Screenplay Mode. Did you know that Scrivener has both a standard text mode and a screenplay mode? You can write screenplays in Scrivener. Yes, you heard that correctly. Instead of buying expensive software, you can use this software that you already have. When you switch over to screenplay mode, you can control the formatting with the tab key, shifting between location, dialogue, character, and action. While it's not as robust as, say, Final Draft Pro, it does work pretty well, especially for an author who may just need to write an occasional screenplay here and there. You can also export your screenplay into Final Draft format, the gold standard for screenplays, if you want to import them into Final Draft later. Number 6 is Custom Metadata. It's an often overlooked but powerful tool to help you stay organized. You're probably familiar with labels in Scrivener, right? The most common way to use those is to label each chapter with the name of a point of view character. That's typically how labels work. But each document can only have one label. What if you wanted to label each chapter in your story with additional tags, such as the setting or the date that you finished a chapter? What if you wanted to tag the chapters where the villain appears so you can access them faster later during editing? Metadata is how you do it. The great part about it is that you can use outline mode to sort your chapters by your metadata. It's extremely flexible, and if you can think of it, you can do it. For example, if I want to sort my chapters by location or tag them using the famous goal motivation conflict method, I can do that. Custom metadata is one of those features that you see at first glance and you brush it off because it doesn't look practical. I certainly did, but it's worth learning. Number 5 is snapshots, an underrated feature. Snapshots are like an insurance policy. Let's say you're deep into editing of a chapter, but you're worried that the story is going in the wrong direction. You want to keep going, but you want to save your edits just in case you don't like where you end up. Use the snapshot feature, Command 5 or Control 5 on Windows, to take a snapshot of the chapter. This will save the current version of your document, and you can revert the changes back using the inspector if you ever need them. Like I said, snapshot is like an insurance policy. Hopefully you'll never need to use your snapshot, but if you do, you'll be so glad you had it. It's helpful because you can save a version of a document without having to save the entire project. Number four is speech mode. You can choose to have Scrivener read your story to you, and the program will serenade you with a lovely robotic voice. Speech mode is helpful during editing because you can hear your story instead of reading it, helping you identify potential pacing issues. You can also change the voice and speed of the narration.
One by one, the lights in the hallway flickered on as the luxury cruiser's generators hummed to life. Kelty Sheffield paused and relaxed a little, hooking her hand coil onto her skirt.
Number three is the threaded corkboard. This is a new feature in Scrivener 3 that allows you to see your index cards on a colored thread based on your document labels. This is effective if you have labels assigned to different characters and you want to follow the arc of those characters. For example, my Android X series follows multiple characters and the chapters switch rapidly between them. The threaded corkboard helps me know what the timeline looks like visually and if I have any gaps that I need to address during editing. We're now at the number two top hidden feature in Scrivener. Are you excited yet? And number two is Linguistic Focus. This is also a new feature in Scrivener 3. Linguistic focus lets you dial down on the parts of speech in a given document. For example, if you want to know every instance of a direct speech in a given chapter, you can use linguistic focus to make everything invisible except for the speech and dialogue. You can also do this for any other part of speech. In addition to being effective, it looks great too, allowing you to fade in and out the surrounding text. This feature has a few practical purposes. If you write fiction, it can help you eliminate pesky adverbs or weak adjectives. You can also zero in on all of your dialogue in isolation. If you write nonfiction, you can laser in on your verbs, ensuring that you're writing clearly. And here we are at number one. The number one Scrivener tip is... Are you ready? I don't know if you guys are ready for this. Maybe we should just stop this video. Just kidding. Okay, here we go. The number one top hidden feature in Scrivener is revision mode. Revision mode is perhaps the most unknown, underrated, but powerful feature that Scrivener offers. You can color code your first draft, second draft, third draft, etc., and then see your manuscript evolve colorfully as you revise. At any given moment, you can know when you wrote a sentence or made an edit. Not to mention that this just looks great. When it comes to editing, being organized is important, and revision mode is one of the many tools that Scrivener provides to make editing easier. It's currently available only in the Mac version right now, but it should be available to Windows users when Scrivener 3 launches for Windows. What's your top hidden feature in Scrivener that people should know about? I'd love to see your comments, and I'd love to know how you guys are using Scrivener. And don't forget to watch the rest of the videos in my Scrivener Essentials series, including a rundown of how to outline your novel in Scrivener and how to edit your novel in Scrivener. And if this is your first time watching, I'd love to have you subscribe. Every week I publish videos just like this one with writing and marketing advice to help you write better and grow your influence with readers. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.